In the previous movie, we used keyframe animation to move our minion tentacles from the top of the chute to the end of the conveyor belt. In this movie, we'll continue to use keyframe animation in conjunction with animation constraints to finish assembling our minion. Open the scene Assembly Line Part 2 Start. The first order of business will be to make this mechanical arm grab an alien body and affix it to our tentacles. However, this arm is a significantly more complex object than the alien tentacle mesh we animated in the previous movie. It's actually made up of a number of smaller geometry objects, joints, and control curves. Usually you'll interact with complex objects like this via an animation control rig. Open the Channel Box Layer Editor and turn on the visibility of Mech Arm Controls layer. Three yellow objects appear near the mechanical arm, a NURBS curve, and two locators. If you select the locator above it and use the Move tool, notice that the arm moves with the locator. Likewise, if you select the circle and use the Rotate tool, the swivel rotates along with it. We use objects like these, commonly referred to as control curves, to control more complex objects without having to select all the smaller objects they're made of. This control rig is also contained in an asset, which displays the control curve attributes together in either the channel box or attribute editor. Some of these attributes have been purposely locked or hidden. As accidentally altering them would cause unwanted behavior from our rig. For more information on assets, see our tutorial on setting up a character asset. With this in mind, start at frame 45 and set keys on the arm controls translation. We'll lower the arm in 10 frames, so at frame 55, use the arm control to lower the arm down to the body, a translate Y value of negative 3.1. Set another key. At frame 65, raise the arm up to a translate Y value of 1, and set another key. At this point, we'll also want to key the rotation of the arm swivel control. At frame 95, rotate the arm to negative 180 degrees over the conveyor belt and set your keys. Now at frame 110, keyframe the arm to a translate Y value of negative 0.735 and a translate Z value of 0.085. Using what you've learned, raise the arm back up and swivel it back. The mechanical arm now mimes its job convincingly. We just needed to actually transfer the minion's body onto its base. While you could do this by keyframing the position and rotation of the body along with the arm, that would be a very complex and ultimately messy process. Instead, we're going to constrain the motion of the body to the mechanical arm using an animation constraint. This allows us to reuse the animation of the mechanical arm. If you switch to wireframe mode, you'll notice that there is a locator inside the magnet. This is what we'll parent the body to. Scrub to frame 55. This is the moment right when the magnet touches the minion's body. Select the locator and then shift select the body. In the animation menu set, go to the constrain menu. We can constrain by physical position via the point constraint, rotation via the orient constraint, or scale via the scale constraint. Since we want both position and rotation, we'll use the parent constraint, which will make the alien body follow any transformation by the locator. Now if you scrub through the animation again, the body sticks to the magnet. Go to the layer editor and turn on the visibility of Minion Bottom Controls layer. A locator appears on top of the tentacle object. This will be the anchor point for our minion's body onto its base. At frame 110, create a parent constraint between the body and the tentacle locator, just as you did with the magnet. We're not quite done yet. If you scrub the animation, the body starts acting strangely. This is because it's being constrained by both the magnet and the alien's body at the same time. We'll need to keyframe the parent constraint's weight to control which locator the body sticks to throughout the animation. First, go back to frame 110 and select the body. In the channel box under Shapes, you'll find the parent constraint along with its weight targets. The two attributes listed represent a weighted value associated with the constraint's targets, in this case the magnet and the tentacles. Think of it like a balance scale in which the constraint's overall weight is divided between both these targets. Set the connection point loc W1 value to 0. This effectively removes any effect of the tentacles on the body, therefore giving complete influence to the magnet. Now scrub back to frame 55. Before we zero out the effect of the magnet, we'll first need to set the rest position to keep the body in place when neither constraint target has influence over it. In the outliner, select the body's main transform group node under the asset. This is the actual node Maya placed the parent constraint on. Select constrain, set rest position. Now set the magnet loc W0's weight to 0. The mechanical arm can move freely again. We're ready to keyframe the influences. First, we'll keyframe the parent constraint completely inactive. Start at frame 54, just before the magnet touches the body. Key the constraint when both its weights are 0. At frame 55, set the magnet's influence to 1, and key both influences. The magnet takes full effect while the body is lifted and swiveled. At frame 109, just before the arm attaches the body to the tentacles, key the constraint again. Finally, at frame 110, set the magnet's influence to 0 and the tentacles' influence to 1, and set the final key. This will shift the constraint's weight to the tentacles. Rewind and play the animation. The arm now successfully attaches the minion's body to its tentacles. By using this method, we've animated the body's transformation very precisely using only 4 keyframes. If we'd manually keyframe the body's transformation values themselves, it would likely have taken many more keyframes, and we wouldn't have been guaranteed a smoother result. We can use the exact same procedure to animate the mechanical claw down the line. First, go to the layer editor and turn on the visibility of Mech Claw Controls layer. Note that by selecting the claw's control curve, you can move it up and down with the Move tool, and open and close it with the Rotate tool. You'll also notice the minion's gun is already parent-constrained to the locator at the center of the claw. At frame 180, key the initial position of the claw. At frame 200, lower the claw until the gun is resting on top of the alien's body, and set another key. At frame 220, move the claw back up to its initial position. As with the body and tentacles, let's set up a second target for this constraint at frame 200, between the gun and the tentacle's locator. As before, set the weight of the tentacle's influence to zero for now. In this case, because the gun starts out in the claw's grasp, we don't actually need to set the rest position or zero out the claw's influence beforehand. We can go right to frame 199 and set a key on the constraint's influences. On frame 200, set the claw's influence to zero and the tentacle's influence to 1. As a final touch, you can keyframe the claw opening on its way up. Now you have a fully built alien rolling onto the transport ship. In the next movie, we'll finish the animation off by using driven keys and texture animation to add some finer details to our scene.